Over to Mr. Tapan Ray, Director General OPI, who's going to make the opening remarks.
Good morning. Distinguished speakers, dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen. Hearty welcome to you all to the symposium on the Indian Patent Act 2005 and impetus to science in India. And as you know, this has been organized by the Organization of Pharmaceutical Producers of India, OPPI, and supported by NASSCOM. Ushering in the product patent regime in India heralds the dawn of a new era. The era that vindicates not only the need to encourage, protect, and reward innovation for the rapid progress of our nation, but also to compete effectively in the knowledge economy with the best in the world to establish India as a leading country with significant share of the global economy. However, it is quite unfortunate that the patents that protect today's innovation and drive research and development to create tomorrow's life-saving treatments are under criticism from some quarters. India chose to follow an alternative to product patent regime for many years, since 1970. In 1970, the Government of India amended its IP laws with a clear objective in mind to reduce the prices of medicines, to improve their access to the ailing population of the country. As a result, some drugs were made cheaper. However, the moot question that we need to address now, was it a panacea? While looking back, it appears it does not. On the contrary, the situation remained as gloomy even thereafter. So far as the access of medicine is concerned, after almost four decades of continuation with the above policy, around 65% of the Indian population still don't have access to cheaper off-patent medicines, against comparative figures of 47% in Africa and 15% in China. Children in our country still go without routine vaccination, though the Government of India has made primary vaccination program free in our country, and that too for all. Even in a situation like this, where affordability is no issue, only about less than 40% of infants within the age group of 12 months to 23 months are fully vaccinated against six major childhood diseases: tuberculosis, diphtheria, pertussis, tetanus, polio, and measles. Moreover, as we know, despite distribution of cheaper generic HIV/AIDS drugs by the government and other organizations, mostly free, for a number of years, only 7% of India's AIDS patients were receiving any drug by the end of 2006. The above two important examples prove the point very clearly that addressing the issue of price alone will not help our country to solve the issue of poor access of medicine to the ailing population of India. Only a sharp focus on rejuvenation of our fragile healthcare system, rapid development of our healthcare infrastructure, and most importantly, building a healthcare financing system through either by the government or through public-private partnership will help address this pressing issue. Indian Patent Act 2005 has paved way for innovation and high-tech research and development within the country. Contrary to adverse forecasts from some quarters, prices of medicine in India have not gone up. However, while medicines play a relatively small role in rising overall healthcare spending, including hospitalization. It is important to ensure that individuals with large healthcare expenses have affordable access to medicine. Thus, a good affordable insurance coverage, both government and private, available to all Indians belonging to various socioeconomic strata, together with the above measures, will help address the key issues of both access and affordability of medicine for all in a holistic way. The attack on patents is not really a defense of patients or the poor. Such attacks help diverting attention from the core healthcare issues, as I have stated before. And these are, I repeat once again, healthcare system, healthcare infrastructure, and healthcare financing. Health of our nation will depend on how well these key issues are being addressed by the policy and decision makers of the country. Our country cannot afford to ignore that intellectual property is one of the keys to prosperity of the great nation of ours. And it should be encouraged, protected, and rewarded under a robust patent act of the country for inclusive growth within India. Coming back to today's symposium, as you have seen, is divided into three sessions. The first session will deliberate on Patent Act 2005 and the Indian experience. The second session will try to answer the question, is regulatory data protection an imperative enabler for research and development? And the final session will address the challenges and dilemmas in IPR. I have no doubt that all of you will immensely enjoy the discourse of the eminent professionals in this field and in all the three sessions, and this will be followed by a very lively panel discussion as a grand finale.